Tired of juggling between taking notes and actively participating in your virtual meetings? This is where Fathom comes in. Fathom is an AI meeting assistant that can join your calls, create AI meeting summaries, action lists, and more. You can use it with Zoom, Google Meet, or Microsoft Teams, and I really like how you can be confident that you don't miss any crucial information while still being able to be engaged during a call. As someone whose primary tool is Notion, I also like that there's an integration with Zapier so that I can create an automated meeting notes database right inside of my Notion. In this video, I'll show you how to get started with Fathom, create an automation with Zapier, and set up the automated meeting tracker Notion database. If you find this video helpful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. So the first step to using Fathom is going to be to go to fathom.video, and then if you don't already have an account, you can go ahead and click the Get Started Free Forever button. Fathom is free to get started, so I highly recommend just trying it out and see if it works for you. I'm going to go ahead and click here. Once you're signed in, I wanted to give you a brief overview of what Fathom has when you start using it. So here you have My Calls. And this is where you can see all of the calls that you have recorded inside of Fathom. Then there's also team calls as well as folders. So if you want to separate your calls into different folders, then there's also playlists where you can share playlists of highlights. And then there's also alerts. And what alerts are is that you can add alerts for certain keywords, and then you can get emails when that keyword has been said during a meeting. On the top here, you'll notice the settings as well as help and feedback. And then there's also the opportunity to try test calls, tutorials, FAQs. And I would highly recommend downloading the app to make sure that you can use it while you're in the call on your desktop and get the correct notifications. And make sure to download that app as well. The next really important thing to do before you actually start using Fathom is to go to the settings here and then make sure that your meeting platform is fully enabled. So for example, I mainly use Zoom, so I have Zoom fully enabled. And then what you can do is auto record unscheduled Zoom meetings, or you can disable recording in progress audio notification. You can also do record gallery mode with improved recording quality if you'd like. So I would make sure to make sure Zoom is fully enabled, or if you use Google Meet or Microsoft Teams, depending on what platform you want to record. The other thing to note is auto record all meetings. You can also choose these settings and then auto share as well. So you can also auto share with all of your attendees so that everyone gets the meeting notes at the end. And then there's also premium features. In this case, I'm going to be showing you a connection with Zapier so that you can automate sending Fathom content to other apps. So that's why this one is also connected. So those are the most important settings to make sure that it's going to really work when you start using Fathom. Next, let's go into a Zoom call. So next, I'm going to go ahead and start my Zoom call so that you can see what happens with Fathom. And now I've started Fathom, and you can see that in my chat, it says Fathom is taking notes and summarizing this meeting. You'll also notice that the Fathom note taker has also joined the meeting as well. So now you'll see that I can click skip and start recording now through Fathom. So I'm going to go ahead and click that in. I can see this meeting is being recorded and I can click OK. Now what's going to happen is Fathom is going to be recording and taking notes throughout the meeting. So during the call, it's also going to show me a monologue counter here so that you can see if you've been talking too much for monologue detection, which I think is really neat. You can also highlight things. So let's say that I want to highlight what I'm saying right now, then I can highlight that and then I can stop the highlight and it's going to track those highlights. Once I'm done with the meeting, I'm just going to end the meeting. So now that I've had my meeting, I can go here to check what that looks like. You can see that Fathom has already created an AI summary for me, which shows the meeting purpose and key takeaways and all of these things. It's also going to show a transcript. I can also ask Fathom about this meeting as well. Then there's also different highlights that I've saved. Here I can choose to share it to other people, and you can also see the attendees, and I can also send that email recording to all attendees as well. The next step I'm going to be showing is how to start creating the automated meeting tracker inside of Notion. So next, I would recommend opening your Notion and creating a new page. Inside here, I'm going to name this something unique so that I can easily find it later. But first, I'm going to go ahead and click this Get Started with Database, Empty Database. And inside here, I'm going to call it Fathom Meeting Tracker. The next thing I'm going to do is basically set up this meeting tracker so that it has the correct properties to really capture the meeting. First thing I'll need is the name. Then I'm going to also add dates so that you can see the time. The other thing that Fathom can do is to also store the URL of that meeting. So I'm going to go ahead and create a URL property. I'm going to rename this to recording URL. The next thing I'm going to add is going to be a text here so that it can show me the duration of the meeting. It's the very basic of a Fathom meeting tracker. You might want to add your own notes somewhere as well, but this is going to allow you to bring in those AI meeting notes directly into your Notion using Zapier. So now that we have this Notion page, I'm going to go to Zapier. So next, I would recommend go to zapier.com and then you can go ahead and log in or sign up depending on whether or not you already have an account. And then you should end up with a page that looks something like this. Go to this plus create and I'm going to create a new Zap. And the first thing I'm going to do is set up the trigger for this app, and that's going to be with Fathom. So I'm going to go ahead and click Fathom, and the trigger event for that is going to be when I have the new AI summary. And then they're going to ask to connect the account, so you can go ahead and sign in through here. So now I've connected here and then I can click continue. Then I can choose this so that it's only triggered on my meetings, and then it's going to test that out. And here we can see a recent AI meeting summary that's been recorded, and you can check that it's correct here. And then I'm going to click out and then continue with the selected record. The next thing I'm going to do is to choose Notion for the next step. And for the action event, I want it to be to create a database item and the account I'm going to sign in. And when you do this, make sure that you have shared the correct pages that include that meeting tracker that we just created inside of Notion. So now I'm going to click continue and then we can start configuring it. The first thing is it's going to ask the particular database. And for this, it's really great to name your database something unique so you can easily find it. You can see here Fathom Meeting Tracker, and then it's going to load all the properties that we just created. So the first thing is going to be the name. So we want the name, if you type slash, to be the meeting title. The next thing is include time with date fields. So here we can say true. And then we can set the start date and time. And then I'm going to look for time. And that's going to be the scheduled start time. And then for the end time, I'm going to also do the scheduled end time. And then the recording URL slash recording. So we can do the recording URL here or the recording share URL. So I'm going to click this one. And then for the duration of the meeting, I'm going to type slash and look for duration. So I can do the recording duration in minutes or meeting scheduled duration in minutes. So depending on which one you want, you can choose one or the other. I'm going to just choose the scheduled duration. And then in the content, this is where you can add your AI meeting summary. So I'm going to look for AI summary. And I'm going to want for the AI summary, a summary with markdown formatting. So I'm going to click this one. And then for the content format, I want it to be markdown. So that's the basics of adding this in. And then I can click continue. So now I'm going to test this step. So I can click test step. And then we can check that everything gets sent over to Notion. So now we can see the Fathom meeting tracker actually have the content inside of here. All of these links go to Fathom, to the specific part of that video. And also you can see the recording URL here, the duration of the meeting and the date as well. So I think this is a really cool thing that you can create and add to your Notion workspaces so that whenever you have your Zoom calls, it's going to automatically get placed inside of here. And you can use this as part of bigger dashboards as well. So once I'm back in Zapier and this works, I can click publish and it's going to start listening for these meetings from now on. And I can go ahead and go home. So now we can see that this one is on, and this is the one where it goes from Fathom all the way to Notion through Zapier. I think Fathom is a really useful tool if you'd like a solution to have an AI meeting assistant in your calls and be able to send out and use that information in flexible workflows. If you're interested in trying out Fathom, who's the sponsor of today's video, be sure to check the link in the description. Let me know if you have any questions or comments, and I hope to see you all in the next video.